In this problem, we're given a table that represents a function relationship. We want to determine the value of z, which is the output here, when the input is 8. And then we want to write a function rule for the entire table. So for this table, these values of n would be the inputs into the function, which would also be the domain of the function. And in the second column, f of n would be the outputs of the function, which would also be the range of the function. Let's take a look at the inputs and see if we can notice a pattern as we go down this list of values. Notice from -4 to 0 would be an increase of 4. And from 0 to 4 is also an increase in 4. From 4 to 8 is also an increase of 4, and so on. So notice that as we work our way down the column, the inputs are increasing by 4. Now if we take a look at the outputs, from -7 to -5 is an increase of 2. From 5 to -3 is also an increase of 2. So if this pattern holds, then z would be equal to -3 plus 2, which would be -1. So let's go ahead and write in here z equals -1. And if z is equal to -1, notice that if we add 2, we would get the next output, and the pattern continues. 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. So we can conclude that z would be equal to -1. Now one more thing we should notice about this table. Notice that the ratio of the change of y to the change of x is constant, which should remind us of a linear equation. So to determine the function rule, we're actually going to write an equation in slope-intercept form, or the form y equals mx plus b, and then rewrite this equation as a function. So we're going to treat this first column, or the inputs, as x values, and we'll treat the outputs, or f of n, as y values. And in slope-intercept form, remember that m is the slope, or the ratio of the change of y to the change of x, and b is the y-intercept. Now looking at our table, notice the change of y is positive 2 when the change of x is positive 4, so our slope would be 1/2. And then the y-intercept occurs when the x value is equal to 0. So if we take a look at this row in the table, notice that when x is 0, y is equal to -5, which means b is equal to -5. So now the linear equation that would produce this table would be y equals 1/2 x, and then since b is -5, we'll write -5. And now to write this as a function rule, we'll replace y with f of n, and x with n. So we'll have f of n equals 1/2 n minus 5. This would be the function rule for the given table. And just to verify this, we could evaluate the function at these given inputs to make sure they match the corresponding outputs. So for example, just to check one of these, let's check to make sure that when the input is 12, the output is positive 1. So f of 12 would be equal to 1/2 times 12 minus 5. Well, half of 12 is 6. 6 minus 5 is equal to 1, which is the output in our table. And we could do this for other inputs, but I'm going to go ahead and stop here. I hope you found this helpful.